There was a dream I had, one of several that involved Liberty Hyde Bailey. I'm looking at an old photograph of my childhood home, and I notice a wood fence line that would ultimately be replaced with a metal chain link fence. The photograph begins moving, like a film, and I notice a small graveyard in the backyard. At closer inspection, one of the gravestones reads Clarence Bailey. For some reason, I know that this is the son of Dana Bailey. Dana Bailey actually was Liberty Hyde Bailey's older brother who died of scarlet fever when Liberty was not even 4. I also find at the gravesite educational leaflets by Bailey's colleague, Anna Botsford Comstock. The dream ends with me feeling fortunate in discovering these historical source materials so close to home. I'm John Stempian, Director Emeritus of the Liberty Hyde Bailey Museum. There's a lot to say about the dream's images and some of its historical inaccuracies, but I want to focus on why did Liberty Hyde Bailey affect me to the degree that aspects of his life story were now entwined in my unconscious. If I had to point to a cause of this, it would be one book that Liberty Hyde Bailey wrote. Here it is, The Holy Earth. I came upon it as an intern at the Bailey Museum before I had any thoughts of working there, let alone as its director. Opening it, this is what I found. So bountiful hath been the earth, and so securely have we drawn from it our substance, that we have taken it all for granted, as if it were only a gift, and with little care or conscious thought of the consequences of our use of it. Nor have we very much considered the essential relation that we bear to it as living parts in the vast creation. And here came the game changer. If God created the earth, so is the earth hallowed. And if it is hallowed, so must we deal with it devotedly and with care that we do not despoil it, and mindful of our relation to all beings that live on it. We are to consider it religiously. Put off thy shoes from off thy feet, for the place whereon thou standest is holy ground. These ideas, in short, brought to word and light my current worldview. If one wants to connect with the divine, one need only recognize their own backyard. We are surrounded by a life that we did not make, that is beyond us, hence holy. The divine is here. It's here, and it's here now, and we have a responsibility to it. See, in action, this means that my composting, like growing a garden, watering from a rain barrel, these aren't just faddish quirks. With this idea of Bailey's, what I do is a sacrament. This book so impressed me as a director that Michigan State Press helped the museum in 2008 to put it back into print. The museum did programs, we did outreach, the museum sold the books, I gave some away to visitors, and one of whom would be this fellow here, John Lindstrom. John was so impressed with the book, he became a museum intern, then a co-curator, and then a director of the Liberty Hyde Bailey Museum after I left. He was even able to coordinate, edit, and produce in a centennial edition with a foreword by none other than environmental writer Wendell Berry. Now, I haven't seen John in over a year, but I'm driving out to meet him this week in Ithaca, New York. Together, we plan on searching for Liberty Hyde Bailey.
In the morning by the sea, as the fog clears from the sand, I have no money in my hand, I have no home, I have no land. But it doesn't trouble me, as I lay beside the fire, I am easy to inspire, there is little.